In this video, you will discover how to supercharge your Amazon advertising campaigns with Xmars, an advanced platform that boosts your return on ad spend using AI-driven optimization, detailed data analysis, and predictive modeling. Plus, don't miss a special offer, which you can get if you follow our link. You will get for 6 months, 25% off. This video is part of the Demo Mondays video series where we invite different Amazon software creators and we ask them to present their solutions just like this on the screen. And now let's jump to Xmars. Hello, Ben. It's nice to meet you. Please tell us what is Xmars and what problems do you solve for Amazon sellers?
Yeah. Hi, Gus. It's nice to meet you as well. So Xmars is an advertising optimization platform for both Amazon and Walmart.com. So we play against most of the same competitors in the space, but I think what really makes Xmars different is the flexibility it gives you as either a seller, or an agency, or an aggregator. So you can use AI to manage your campaigns to do optimizations. You can use rules-based automation and also make bulk manual changes. So you could have 60% of your campaigns run by AI, where you go and focus on the rest of them with either rules-based or manual tools. So it's very unique. I've never seen any other platform that lets you choose exactly what type of tools to use on each campaign.
And soon we will learn through the real demo. And before we jump to the presentation of the tool, can you also explain to what kind of users are you targeting? What kind of sellers, big, small, is this tool the best fit?
Yeah, I think this tool works for almost every seller. You just use it differently. So this tool can be used by a large agency, an aggregator, or a large brand with a big catalog, or by a smaller seller. So maybe someone spending less than $10,000 a month on advertising. You can still find efficiency using AI or any of the tools that we have in the platform through a couple things. One, you're getting hourly data and doing hourly adjustments, but also there's tools that you don't have in the ad console. So I would really say it can work for anyone that's advertising on Amazon.
Right. Amazing. So let's jump to your tool. Let's see how it works and how does it help Amazon sellers.
So this is inside of Xmars. So you can see here we have Amazon and Walmart, which you can toggle between. And what you're seeing here is just our main dashboard. So this is going to give you all of your high level metrics and reporting that would come that would be with your Amazon advertising. So you can see your total sales, your spend, ad sales, orders, tacos, ROAS. We have this alerts and opportunities section here, which is really great for, you know, at the beginning or end of the day, go through and see what campaigns are performing well and what campaigns aren't performing well. So everything on the left here will be low performing campaigns or products that you might want to take a look at. And everything over here in green means that something's going well. So there's a lot of data within this dashboard, but I won't go too deep into this. Let's look over to the left here to the navigation bar. So you have your dashboards. We have the main one, but you can also build your own customized dashboards in here. We have our product center. This is where you can pull in all of your seller central or vendor central data and be able to see your total sales alongside your advertising metrics. Everything AI is going to live in our AI Copilot section here. So we'll dive into this next. The ads management section is going to have tools like our budget pacer, looking at your advertising on a portfolio view. And then this is where you do all of your bulk manual operations and also see all of your advertising specific reporting. So you can see that based on ad type here or everything aggregated together. Additionally, if you're using Xmars for Amazon DSP advertising, your DSP access would be right here. We have an advanced reporting tab as well that will show you a full funnel summary. So all of your data on an hourly level for all your different ad types and on whatever time frame you want to see it on. Scheduled reports. And then same thing with more reporting for DSP and share of voice. Next, we have our advanced tools section here where you have our rules-based automation, our lock ad placements, which is a very unique top of search ranking tool that we have. And then our rank tracker and labels. And the last thing you'll see here is our AMC Hub. This is Amazon Marketing Cloud. So these are pre-templated reports. Now, if you are using Amazon Marketing Cloud right now, you can access all different types of reports and models and build audiences without using any SQL queries. So the next thing I'll go into is our AI managed campaigns. So Xmars AI is taking several different actions to optimize your account. So most other AI tools will focus on a couple actions like bidding or keyword harvesting. Now, Xmars AI does the following. So we'll do bid optimization and bid day parting, budget optimization and budget day parting, keyword harvesting and mitigation, then also pausing and underperforming ASINs and ad groups. So with all that together, it will do all the actions that you would do as an ad manager on a tactical level, and then you're there to drive the strategy. So we call this AI Copilot for a reason. It can be as automated as you want, but really it's there to help you as an ad manager get better results, but also get a lot more time back in your day. So there's two ways to add AI on top of campaigns in Xmars. You can either build new campaigns or you can add it on top of your existing campaigns. And I'll quickly show you how to do both. So if we want to launch new campaigns, we'll go to Smart Creation. And then we can select between Sponsored Products, Sponsored Brand, Sponsored Display, and DSP. And then we can do multiple ASINs at once if we were, say, want to relaunch a whole new account. But let's just say we have a new product or a product we want to restructure for. I'll just select the ASIN right here, and I'll click Next. And here's where you begin to customize the AI. We emphasize trying to give you as much control over the AI as possible because we don't want it to be a black box. We want you to set it up the right way for each of your products and then have a log and areas where you can see every change the AI is making. So first thing we're going to do is give the AI an objective. We want to give AI a way to think about the advertising. How would it approach it? So out of the three objectives we have, two are focused on increasing sales. Drive growth is just going to be your standard everyday objective for if you want to increase sales over time and prioritize sales over an ACoS target. Maintaining stable orders is our efficiency focused objective. So this one is great at reducing ACoS over time. So if I select this one, it's going to give me a recommended range that's lower than the historical performance. And if I select this one, it's going to be slightly above that historical performance of the product. So if I select this and I want to say, get this product from a 26% ACoS down to a 15% ACoS, I'd select this. I'd set this to the lower end of the range and then come back in 1 to 2 weeks and keep bumping it down as those campaigns continue to perform and get more and more efficient. You're also going to have a recommended daily budget. And when you're setting the budget here, you want to think of it, you're setting it for the product. So our AI will distribute this budget between all the campaigns that you end up creating in this process. So for now, we'll leave it here at 300, right in the middle of the recommended range, and we'll continue. AI personality here is an additional layer of customization on top of the objective, which is like the mindset of the AI. AI personality is going to tell AI how much data it needs to ingest before it makes a decision. So if I set this to conservative, I'm saying AI, you need to ingest more significantly or statistically significant data before you decide to change a bid or alter my budget day parting schedule or my bid day parting schedule. If I set this to 5, we're saying that it can take less data before it makes a decision. So this is going to make more decisions faster, but with less data. So I think, you know, you can balance this to say, we want to be really aggressive. We want to make a lot of changes, move very fast, or we want to be very conservative with the changes we make and make sure there's enough data to justify those. You can never go wrong with 3. That's what I always say. Now here, we're picking all of our different campaign tactics. So right now, we're looking at doing some broad match, phrase match, and exact match keyword targeting. Same thing with product category targeting. Maybe let's add in some competitor keywords as well. We have an auto campaign, and we could add in our branded keywords as well. So when I click Next, we give you the option to choose between 3 different campaign structures here. Now, 90% of your campaigns will likely fall into this standard structure. I think this is an overall best practice by just splitting each ad group into a single manual campaign and then having one auto campaign. Now, this is great and easy for harvesting. We can just harvest any keywords that are performing and bring them into the proper campaign. We also have 100% control over the budget that's being associated to each match type. So standard structure will work for 90% of your products. If you have a really, really low daily budget, maybe something around $10 to $5, you'd maybe use a binary structure here, which is just going to create two campaigns and separate your tactics on an ad group level right here. And then finally, if you have a large enough budget to accommodate it, you could build a precise structure, which will be single keyword and single target campaigns. As we move forward through this, we can see that AI is ready to build all these different campaigns for us, and it's actually recommended some targets. And these keyword and product targets will come from a couple of different places, but primarily the historical performance of the campaigns and the products, also Amazon brand analytics, and then our own proprietary scraping. You can add in your own keyword lists manually. So I recommend when you get to this phase and you're reviewing the targets, you spend about 10 to 15 minutes either inputting your own targets, reviewing the ones the AI has added, and tweaking the starting bids. So from here, AI has distributed the budget between all of our campaigns. We can also tweak this, but AI is going to alter this on an ongoing basis. And the last thing you can do is add a custom naming rule here. So if I want to name my campaigns a certain way every time, I can set this up so that I have my own naming template for both campaigns and ad groups. Now, again, we're all about giving you as much control over the AI as possible. So what we also implemented are these AI action space settings. So what you're seeing below are all the different actions the AI is doing. And I have the option to either customize these or toggle them on or off. So let's just say I don't want AI to do any keyword harvesting. I can turn that off because I want to do that all manually myself. I could also turn off negation. I could turn off budget dayparting or budget reallocation. Now, budget reallocation would be for these 10 campaigns we're creating. AI is able to move budget between the different campaigns on a daily basis. I can also set in a cap or a minimum for my bids. So, and oftentimes a fear with AI is that it's just going to look at the data and bid $10 for a certain keyword. Just for peace of mind, we can ensure that it's not going to exceed a certain bid. But also, if we need to make sure bids are high to maintain different top of search rankings, we could input a minimum bid as well. So this is fully customizable. I can choose exactly what AI is doing and then put the right guardrails in place. But once everything looks good to me here, I'll just click create, and we've launched 9 different campaigns and 13 ad groups, and AI is off and running. Now, not everyone's going to want to launch all new campaigns, and we understand that. You might have some historical campaigns that perform really well, or no one just has the time for that. So you can also attach AI on top of all of your existing campaigns. So instead of going to Smart Creation, I would just click Add Managed Group, click my ad type, and it's going to pull in all my campaigns here. And I can choose to group these anyway, but I would choose to group them based on either similar performance coming from a similar product, or they're going to have the same objectives. So I'll grab a couple campaigns here that I want to group together. Confirm. And then now I go through those similar optimizations and setup that I did before. So you have your objective, your target ACOS, daily budget for the group, personality, and then the action space settings. So once I configure this, once I attach AI, my main optimizations that I would be doing is coming back every 1 to 2 weeks to either tweak my ACOS targets or tweak any of the action space settings. So I can click edit, come in here, and I could maybe change this ACOS target, change the budget, change the personality based on how performance is trending. The next tab I'll show you is our ads management tab. And this one's looking at specifically sponsored products. And this is just where you can see most of your reporting in XMARS, but also make quick manual changes. So for example, let's just say we want to increase bids across the board on a certain group of keywords. I can filter this any type of way by ASIN, by SKU, by different metrics. And I could come in, grab a bunch of my keywords, do a bulk operation, adjust bid. And I could do this based on the current bid and increase or decrease by a fixed value or by a percentage. So let's just say we want to decrease bids 50% across the board. It's like decrease 50, and then that's going to reduce all of my bids. The other thing that's in here is a log. So this log will show you every single change that the AI is making or someone makes in the Amazon console. And a good thing to remember here with XMARS is that it's two-way compatible. So any change you make in the ad console will be reflected in XMARS and vice versa. Now, the next tool I'll show you is fairly unique to XMARS. So that's going to be our lock ad placements. And I have this loaded over here. So lock ad placements is a tool that uses rules-based automation and then scraping. So if I want to create a rule here, I can basically pick my keyword and my ASIN that I want to run this for. And I'll pick the hours of the day and days of the week that I want to hold a certain paid position. So let's just say being top of search in that front row, maybe the top three positions, is extremely important for your conversion rates, whether you're launching a new product or you know it's just a fast purchase. So I could find my peak hours of the day and just say I want to float between 1 and 3. I can set my highest bid to be a fixed amount and then what my incremental adjustment will be. And the real secret sauce of this is that we're scraping every 15 minutes for that keyword in your ASIN from all these different zip codes in the US and in the UK. So what that allows you to do is optimize your position and make adjustments if you're not floating in that top three. So let's say we scrape and we find that you are sitting at rank 4. We would go and increase your bid by 25 cents. And then in 15 minutes, we check again and see, okay, they're in the third placement. That's good. We can hold it there. And then we can see after 4 successful target placement locks, let's try and reduce the bid so we can get a little bit more efficient. So this tool, if you have it configured properly, can hold you within that certain range that you set with 99% certainty. So the next tool I'll show you in here is our AMC Hub. That's Amazon Marketing Cloud. Now, there's been a lot of buzz around AMC and the Marketing Cloud, but it hasn't really been accessible to most sellers. This will be changing likely in the next coming months. And what Amazon Marketing Cloud is it is a database of all of your user level data for Amazon ads. So anyone that's been exposed to a sponsored display ad, clicked on a sponsored product ad, been exposed to a sponsored brands ad, as well as a DSP ad, now you have a unique user ID for them. And you can use this data. It is your most precise data that you have about your advertising. You can access metrics in here, like due to brand sales for sponsored products. I can also see the entire journeys that my customers are taking. So what ad types are they clicking before they finally make a purchase? And then if I'm running DSP ads, I can use this data to go and build custom audiences. So let's think of it as like I'm bundling my highest converting, my highest performing shoppers, and I'm serving them up with an ad that I know is 100% relevant for them. Right now, you can get access to AMC. You don't do DSP directly through XMARS. So if this is something you're interested in, please feel free to contact our team. We can get you set up with an AMC instance. Now, I'll show you a couple of these models because they are fairly interesting. And again, this is data that you haven't been able to see before in the ad console or anywhere else. So this is our path to conversion model. And what you're seeing here are all the different paths that someone's taking before they finally make a purchase. So for example, we can see all the metrics like total ROAS here, for DSP sponsored products, but what about sponsored products to DSP, or a mixture of sponsored display to sponsored products? How many sales are we getting from those different paths, and how effective are these different ad types? So maybe we're looking through here and we see that sponsored brands isn't really interacting with many of our purchase paths. That could be an indication that we should decrease budget there. Or we can see that DSP is very intertwined with everything that's either has a high ROAS or generating a lot of sales. I can edit these tables very easily by putting in whatever metrics are important to me. I could also filter the paths. So I could do anything that includes, let's say, sponsored brands, anything that includes sponsored products, or maybe let's exclude sponsored products. And let's see what our advertising paths look like that aren't even touched by sponsored products. Now, with each of the models in XMARS, you're able to modify these to specific campaigns and specific ASINs. So what you're seeing there is pulled at a full brand level view, but you might want to look at specific subsets of your catalog. So you can just copy and paste your ASINs in here, and you can also customize the time frame. Maybe you want to look at all the paths for the past 365 days or just Q4. So again, you can customize these models any type of way you want down to the ASIN level. And that's what's unique about XMARS. Now, to pull this data without a visualization tool like XMARS, you would have to write SQL queries in the AMC console, and you would get back an Excel table. So we want to make things very user-friendly and easy for you to quickly come in here, see the data, make decisions on it, and then go help inform your advertising strategy. Another model we have is called our cross-product association model. So what this model does is show you the associations between your entire catalog. So I call this the cross-selling model or the bundling model. But what this is going to show you is, for a particular ASIN, how does it associate with everything else in your catalog? So for example, let's just look at alternative purchases here. So when I look at this ASIN, everyone that views the detail page of this ASIN and doesn't convert, it looks like a fair amount of them go and buy another product in our catalog. So what does this tell us? That, okay, a lot of people view this ASIN. Maybe it's our drives up most traffic. It's our hero product. Now, maybe we should show this one in the product carousels or cross-sell a sponsored display or DSP. But there is a relationship there, and maybe the shoppers that are looking at this are also a really good fit for this product. Anything simultaneous means they buy this ASIN and then this one as well in the same shopping cart. So this is an amazing cue to do a virtual bundle or retarget someone with this product after they've bought it. And then finally, subsequent purchases means they buy this product and then in a separate journey, they come back and buy another product. So again, good cue for cross-selling, creating a virtual bundle, or just knowing that you should be targeting those shoppers that buy this product with this product as well.
In this report, we see only our catalog products, also competitor and other products.
Correct. This is just going to be your own catalog's product. So everything AMC in the Amazon Marketing Cloud console is going to be your own data for your own products. Now, what's also cool about AMC is for a limited time free right now, you would have a trial of the flexible shopping insights data. This is all of your organic data as well. So this will, again, what we're looking at is just ads exposed. If we add in this right here, we're going to see all of our organic data as well. So people that haven't even been touched by your ads before, but they've been exposed to your products. So these are shoppers that you haven't really been reaching with your advertising, and you can expand that reach and then finally go ahead and convert them with this different data. Now, the last model I'll show you is our customer lifetime value report. If you sell any type of consumable product, whether it's a supplement, a beauty product, you name it, lifetime value is extremely important in driving your advertising strategy. So we can see all these monthly cohorts broken up right here, and then what their LTV is and how it grows. So everyone that made their first purchase in March is going to be counted in this March cohort. And their LTV will start at around $28. more people will buy in March as well. And then as they go and continue to repurchase throughout the year, we can see the LTV of a shopper that we acquired in March is actually $45 by the end of the year versus just $28 when they start. Now, how does this relate to advertising strategies? Well, I can drill down this query to one, look at specific ASINs, but also specific campaigns. So I could compare different campaigns, maybe one that has a ROAS of 2 and then another campaign that has a ROAS of 4. But after a full year's view, we can see that that campaign with a 2 ROAS is actually driving a much higher ROAS in LTV than the ROAS that looks higher on paper. So this can be really useful in just figuring out where you should be putting your dollars for longer term growth. And obviously the goal is to, if you have a consumable product, you're getting subscribe and save and repeat purchases that you don't have to pay for. But I would say that's it for our tool. If anyone's interested in learning more, there's a lot more to show in here. And you can reach out to our team and we can definitely set you up with a longer demo.
And could you explain shortly about Walmart integration? I see the Walmart icon on the left. And also there is a Google Ads. Do you also run Google Ads through your platform?
So Google Ads is still in beta. This isn't something that's operational yet. And then Walmart is live and we don't have demo data for Walmart per se, but we have our AI copilot fully running. So you can have AI advertising or optimizing your bids and your budgets. And then we have our ads management section and rules-based automation for Walmart.
Okay. So some Amazon sellers are selling also on Walmart. So it can be a very good integration within one account, everything to see.
Yeah. It's super easy to use both and AI can manage everything for you.
All right. Thank you for this demo. Could you give us an overview of what other features you're planning to release to your users in the next months?
Yeah, absolutely. So a few key features that are coming out in the platform. First is inventory-aware advertising. So you'll be able to create rules based on inventory awareness and then integrate that with the AI campaigns or any other campaigns that you're running. Omnichannel dashboards and omnichannel expansion is also on the forefront. So you'll have dashboards that will be able to integrate both Amazon and Walmart. And then just expanding our capabilities on Walmart and then eventually other marketplaces. AMC is going to continue to improve and expand in the different models that we'll have, the ease of analytics, and then also audience creation capabilities. And then finally, our DSP self-service is just live now. So anyone looking to run DSP ads outside of having an agency run it for them can go and get direct access through Xmars like they would with sponsored ads.
All right. Amazing. So now you have different kind of services, let's say Amazon, Walmart. Within Amazon, there is AMC, DSP. I would like to see the pricing. How does it, reflect to different maybe regions of Amazon, different services you're offering? So let's go through the pricing.
Yeah. So if we're just looking for sponsored ads, it's going to be the pricing that you see here below. And this is for the monthly rates. Now, if you are a larger spender or an agency, we obviously have different packages and offerings for you there. Same thing with AMC and DSP. Those are all custom quoted based on the volume that someone's going to be spending and how many instances they'll have. So for any of those, come to us, but anything else you see here would just be the base pricing for month to month.
For Walmart integration, it's additional cost or it's included?
Walmart is an additional cost and that would be 3% of ad spend. So it's slightly different pricing structure.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you very much. And as we see on the screen, we have a special offer for our listeners, 25% off your first 6 months. So it's worth to try.
Absolutely. And feel free to use this QR code here to book a demo with us or just come in through our website.
All right. Thank you very much, Ben. It was nice to learn about Xmars. And those who want to try, you'll find the special offer and the link in the description as well. And thank you very much, Ben, and good luck in your business. Bye-bye.
Awesome. Thanks, Augustus. Nice to meet you.
I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you feel that Xmars might help in your Amazon business, Check out the link in the description for a 25% special discount for you for the first 6 months. If you have additional questions, reach out to their support or leave a comment below in the comment section, and we will make sure to get Xmars team answer to bring answer for you. And if you like the content we create, don't forget to hit like and subscribe to our channel if you haven't done so yet. And now I would like to invite you to watch the next video where you will learn more advertising, Amazon advertising strategies you can implement right away. So check this out.